Hey, 42 here. This stoutly man is rich Uncle Pennybags. But you knew that, didn't you? Known to many simply as Monopoly Man. He's known for his waistcoat, jacket, top hat, mustache, and of course, his monocle. But wait a minute. The Monopoly Man has never had a monocle. I know, you're absolutely certain that he does, but I promise you, Mr. Pennybags has never, ever had a monocle. You have made it up entirely. This image doesn't exist. Don't panic, you're not alone. The vast majority of people are absolutely certain that they remember the Monopoly Man with a monocle. So what's going on here? Well, these people, and possibly yourself, have all fallen victim to the Mandela effect. The Mandela effect is when a great number of people remember something in a completely different way to how it actually was, or remember an event that never actually happened. You know those times when your mind betrays you? You are certain it happened that way, but the facts say otherwise. It happens to us all, and psychiatrists have a word for it: confabulation. A confabulation is a disturbance or distortion of a memory. But some people say there's more to the Mandela effect than a simple distortion of memory, and the real reason that millions of people's memories are betraying them is far more terrifying and sinister. The name Mandela effect is named after the man himself, ex-president of South Africa, Nelson Mandela. In 1962, Mandela was arrested and thrown in jail for 27 years for starting a workers' strike at a time when South Africa was led by a minority white rule with an iron fist. Black and white were segregated. This was the apartheid. A large number of people around the world vividly remember seeing footage broadcast on television of Nelson Mandela dying inside prison during the 80s. They even remember seeing his funeral live on international TV. Of course, this isn't true. Mandela was released from prison, became president, and died in 2013 at home. So what's going on here? How come millions recall seeing his death in the 80s? Well, it's the first big mystery that coins the term Mandela effect. People are constantly discovering new examples of the Mandela effect. In recent years, many have come into the public eye via the internet. One of the most spine-tingling is the mystery of the Berenstain Bears. The American viewers among us will remember a series of children's books from the 60s onwards. This lovable family of bears was a significant part of everybody's childhood in the US. There were over 300 books in total, and not to mention a TV series in 2003 that went by the same name, the Berenstain Bears. But here's the truly shocking thing. The Berenstain Bears never existed. Sure, there was a cute family of bears, but they were actually called the Berenstain Bears with an A. This has seriously messed with the heads of millions of Americans, because quite literally everyone knew it as the Berenstain Bears. Many have said it's down to the creators changing the name at some point, because Berenstain sounds less Jewish than Berenstain. But the name was never changed. It was named after the two creators, Stan and Jan Berenstain. But something eerie is definitely going on here. There are some very rare examples of official merchandise being uncovered deep from the back of people's garages and attics, showing the franchise being spelt Berenstain, such as on this old VHS. But to confuse matters even further, the name on the front of the tape is spelt Berenstain. Creepy. But could this just be no more than a typo by the graphic designer? You remember the most famous line from Star Wars, don't you? "Luke, I am your father." Except that line was never said in the films. What Darth Vader actually said was, "No, I am your father." A small difference, sure, but then why does the whole world keep saying, "Luke, I am your father"? There's more. Remember Silence of the Lambs? Everyone knows what Hannibal said to Clarice when they first met. I mean, it's only the most famous quote from the entire film. He said, hello, Clarice. Nope, never said it. That line never appeared in the film. Though believe me, go and watch it. Hannibal actually said a rather forgettable, good morning. Even the University of Richmond quoted the fictitious line in a scientific paper. Even people who have never seen Silence of the Lambs are familiar with Hannibal Lecter's sinister, hello Clarice. Another stark example then of the Mandela effect. Remember Sex in the City? It was actually called Sex and the City. The Kit Kat logo doesn't have a dash in it. It never has. The Queen in Snow White never said mirror, mirror on the wall. Oh, and remember Jiffy, the well-known American peanut butter? There's no such thing. It's called Jiff, not Jiffy. Hell, I'm British and even I recall it being called Jiffy. But then is that just because that's what millions of other people have been calling it all this time? The Flintstones was actually called the Flintstones, despite no one in the history of mankind ever calling it that. So, is there an explanation to all of this? Well, kind of. There are three theories that do explain the Mandela effect, but all of them are equally as terrifying. The first popular explanation involves parallel universes. Some believe that we live our lives not just within one universe, but we are instead slipping and sliding between multiple universes within the multiverse without ever realizing it. Each universe is ever so slightly different, and some believe that the Mandela effect is people noticing the minor differences between these other dimensions or universes. Or perhaps we don't travel between universes. What if we've always been in the same universe, but instead memories are leaked from other universes and seep into our universe as they intertwine and collide? This rather outlandish theory isn't currently backed up by any specific research. But that doesn't mean it isn't scientifically possible. New quantum mechanics theories suggest that there are multiple universes and they do interact with each other, possibly sharing information. So, when we remember something vastly different to what the archives tell us, is it information coming from a parallel universe, or is it something far more sinister? As we all know, if something strange happens, there's a conspiracy theory surrounding it. It's the second law of the internet, after don't click on strange links. Mandela effect conspiracy enthusiasts believe the infamous Illuminati, or whatever shady group of men in suits are running the world from behind the scenes, have actually changed subtle elements of history to better suit their new world order. Just hoping that we wouldn't notice. But oops, some people have. Why an omnipotent group of secret world leaders would think that the Monopoly Man's monocle wasn't quite fitting for their new world order is anybody's guess. But what if you actually made all of this up? And this is the most terrifying of all the explanations, because this implies that our memories are nowhere near as reliable as we thought. Yet, what I'm about to tell you is by far the most scientifically accepted explanation for the Mandela effect. Psychologists say that we remember these events, books, films, and images so vividly differently to how they actually are because we've all created false memories. What do you remember most about your childhood? Is it what you ate for dinner each night or what you watched on TV? Your memories of these things are probably fuzzy at best, yet you can remember the names of all of your friends, and that time when you broke someone's window playing football. You probably remember all the times you were naughty, and that's because you talked about those events afterwards with your friends. Your parents talked to you about it afterwards. You received punishment in relation to that event. Conversation is arguably the most powerful memory creator there is, and talking about an event after it happened creates far stronger memories than whilst the event is actually taking place. Memories are created by connections forming in the brain. Your brain is full of cells called neurons, and connections between them called synapses. Imagine a neuron that represents a window and another that represents a ball. As a child, the moment you kick that ball through Batshit Bob's window, a physical synaptic connection was created in your brain between these two neurons, thus forming a weak memory of the event. But then, when you tell your mates about how you just broke Batshit Bob's window, that connection actually gets thicker, strengthening that memory. Then, when your mum confiscated your Game Boy afterwards, the connection grows once again. But it goes even further. Every time you recall that memory from here on out, the connection gets stronger. By simply remembering something, you are strengthening that memory forever. Of course, this also means that if you remember something wrongly, every time you remember what actually happened, you are instead strengthening the incorrect memory that's already there. This is why we can't see past our memories. Our brains tell us that they are unquestionably reliable, but we have no way to know whether that memory was false to begin with, until someone comes along and tells us or shows us that we have remembered it incorrectly. This is called false memory, and it is by far the most likely thing that's causing the Mandela effect. In 1974, psychologists Loftus and Palmer showed 45 students a clip of a real car crash, then asked a question. How fast were the cars going when they hit each other? The range of answers were vastly unreliable, but it was also discovered that by changing the wording of the question also completely changed the people's answers. Those who were asked how fast were the cars going when they contacted each other gave a much slower speed than those who were asked how fast were the cars going when they smashed into each other, demonstrating just how unreliable memories can be and how our conversations with others can distort our memories. Mandela didn't die in the 80s like many thought, but in 1990 he was released from prison. The event was significant and was broadcast on TV across the world, with millions tuning in to watch. There was a large state procession on the streets of South Africa to celebrate his release, which many Americans and others remember watching. But such an event could easily be misconstrued to have been a funeral procession. Nelson Mandela's name was nowhere near as famous back then as it is now, so people may not have paid much attention to what was actually happening at the time, thus creating a false memory that he died. The Berenstain Bears was read by school kids who couldn't give a toss about proper spelling. Steen is also a far more common suffix to a surname than Stain, so it makes perfect sense that children simply called it the incorrect name of Berenstain Bears when discussing the book with friends, and so grew up with this false memory. The same logic applies to movie quotes. You've probably heard "Luke, I am your father," and "Hello, Clarice," many, many more times in real life during conversations with others than you have heard them in the actual films, at least the part in the film where the line was supposed to be. It turns out that every instance of the Mandela effect can be explained by collective false memory, which is disappointing to some and scary to others. The simple fact that everyone you speak to shares the same misconceptions about something actually strengthens that false memory. You've likely spread misinformation to hundreds of others when you've quoted lines from films that were never said and discussed events very differently than what actually happened. We are all part of the problem, and new examples of the Mandela effect will continue to surface because nobody's memory is perfect, and I for one welcome them because that's what makes us human, and such curiosities keeps life so interesting. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, support me on Patreon before you forget who I am and tell your friends you watched a guy on YouTube called 36. Click up there to become a patron. Doing so helps me to make better videos. And click down there to watch another video. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe.